I am Dr. W. Vikunare from Kamala Nil Mahavidyalaya Nagpur. Today we are going to discuss the peptide linkage. And here, what is meant by peptide bond, and what are the nomenclature of peptide, and after that, what are the different types of peptide linkage, and how the formation of peptide linkage. And as we know that amino acid contain carboxylic acid group and also amino group. So hydrogen from NH2 and OH from the CH group, there is a loss of water molecule and we get the peptide linkage, that is CONH is the peptide linkage. And so there are different types of peptide linkage compounds are there, dipeptide, tripeptide, tetrapeptide and lastly the polypeptide compounds. So when the large number of amino acid group combine together forming a polypeptide. So in this way we are going to discuss the structure of polypeptides and the formation of polypeptide and what are the drawbacks of these polypeptide bonds that we are going to discuss in today's presentation. So the topic is peptide, that is the peptide linkage or peptide bond and different aspect about these peptides. So first is we are going to discuss here what is meant by peptide bond or what is peptide. So we can say that peptide are amides formed by the interaction between amino group and a carboxylic acid group of the different amino acids. And group, that is a amide group, NHCO. This NHCO is known as peptide bond, also known as peptide linkage. And scientist is there, Emile Fischer, in 1902, says that characteristic structural features of this peptide and the protein which contain large number of peptide chain in the peptide linkage. This is also known as peptide theory of protein. And in this case, two amino acid can combine with the elimination of water and a reaction is taking place between carbonyl group of one amino acid and the amino group of other. So in this case the reaction is shown here how the peptide linkage is formed. And also as we know the different types of peptides are there. And so in short we can say that peptide are amide formed by the condensation of amino group of one alpha amino acid with the carboxyl group of the other amino acid with the elimination of a water molecule. And it is shown here in the next slide. This is here, this is one amino group, amino acid, this is another, and here H from this and OH, this water get eliminated. So there is a loss of OH and H from this. So CONH linkage is here, CONH. So this CONH is the amide group, this group is known as peptide linkage or peptide bond. And so here shown, this is the CONH group and this CONH is called the peptide bond or the peptide linkage. And so in this way, two or more different amino acids combine and forming different types of dipeptide, polypeptide like that. Compounds are formed which contain peptide linkage or peptide bond. And after that we are going to see the what are the different types of or the classification of peptide. So peptide are classified into dipeptide, tripeptide, tetrapeptide and the lastly the polypeptide depending upon the 2, 3, 4 or many molecules of same or different amino acid combined together. So depending upon the whether we are taking 2, 3, 4 or many molecules of same or different amino acid for combination and depending upon that we get different types of compound. And therefore we can classify the peptide as a dipeptide, tripeptide, tetrapeptide or polypeptide. And here is shown in this here is shown R dash R2 dash may be same or different alkyl groups. And here this is one amino acid group, second and third. So here there is a loss of water, n number of water. So here H from this here H2O is a replace and we get CONH here in this way. CONH. This is CONH. So this is the polypeptide linkage repeated n times. So we get a long chain and in which alkyl groups may be same or different depending upon that. So we can classify peptide into dipeptide, tripeptide, tetrapeptide or polypeptide if the number of molecules are more than 3 or 4. So large numbers are there, then it is a polypeptide. So this is the one. From the alpha amino acid, when they combine, we get this peptide linkage and a polypeptide long chain of the compound is formed. So in the next part now we are going to see a nomenclature of peptide, how to name the peptide compounds. And in case of a nomenclature, it is clear that each polypeptide chain has a NH3 plus group on one end and called N terminal end, and on the other hand a free CO minus on the other end called C terminal end. So left side having N terminal, right side having C terminal end. And as we know that peptide are always written with the N terminal amino acid, and that with the free NH2 group on the left and the C terminal amino acid free CH group on the right. The name of the peptide are obtained by the names of amino acid from N terminus or C terminus, and the suffix INE of all the amino acid except C terminus amino acid is replaced by the suffix YL. Thus name of the peptide is always written as one word, and name of peptide are abbreviated by writing the three letter abbreviation for amino acid from left to right. For example, here is given, these are the two, this is glycine, another molecule of glycine. So in this way there is a loss of water, H2 and O, there is a loss of water and forming this type of NH3 CH2 CONH, CO and NH, H2 and O is the loss of water molecule and CONH CH2 CO. So this is the compound glycine glycine. So first is the glycine, so suffix is YL and then glycine, glycine glycine and gly-gly, three letters we have to take. So in short GLY gly-gly, this is the two, we have taken two molecules of glycine, therefore it is known as dipeptide compound. We can also take different types of glycine and alanine. So in this case also this is glycine and this is the compound of alanine. And so there is also loss of H2 and O, water is here elimination, and the CONH here is a linkage, and this is known as glycyl alanine. So this is glycyl, YL again we have to add here, glycyl alanine. So gly-ala, it is also a dipeptide. In the another case, that is alternately the amino group of the glycine may react with the CH group of alanine, resulting in the formation of different dipeptide, and which is known as alanine glycine. So ala gly, so here this is alanine and this is glycine, so forming again now here H2O, there is elimination of water, and here CONH linkage is there. So this is known as alanine glycine, because first compound alanine glycine, so YL and then glycine ala gly. So in this way, and these are the in all the case 1, 2, 3 are the three examples of the in which we have taken two molecules of amino acid and forming the dipeptide. But now there also form, if you take three molecules 1, 2, 3, then tripeptide molecule can also be formed here. So this is the molecule alanine, this is glycine and this is phenylalanine. And by taking three we get this tripeptide, which is known as, this is the structure of tripeptide alanine glycine phenyl alanine. So this is alanine glycine phenyl alanine. So this is the tripeptide. So in this way we can give the name and we can write the name of that compound. So this is the procedure to write the name of the peptide compounds. Now geometry of peptide bond, and in case of geometry, different here is shown bond angle and details about that. So X-ray analysis of dipeptide and polypeptide have shows that entire peptide linkage is a flat. The carbonyl carbon and nitrogen and the four atoms attached to it all lie in a same plane. So carbon nitrogen distance has been determined and it is 132 picometer. And we against the normal CN bond distance of 147 picometer. This suggests that carbon nitrogen bond in di or polypeptide has 50% double bond character. Therefore, the bond angle of the bonds to the nitrogen are similar to those around trigonal carbon atom. And here the bond angles are shown in this peptide bond, geometry of peptide bond. This bond angle is a 123, this is 1.4, this is 123. In this case, it is shown here in this group. So this is the C, this is CONH, and again C here CHR dash CONH. So in this way, the bond distances are shown on the basis of X-ray method. So this is structure of the peptide bond is shown here, bond angle and bond length. And in the next slide also, we can show that structure of peptide. And in this case, since carbon and nitrogen bond has 50% double bond character, the lone pair of electron on the nitrogen in the peptide bond is delocalized over the CO group. And it is shown here, two regional structure of the peptide bond is shown here. This is one structure, and now this electron pair shifted here, so become double bond, and this double bond becomes here, so this is the negative charge. So here, the two regionating structure, this is covalent structure and this is the ionic structure. So the two structures of peptide bond is shown here. So delocalized of the electron pair is there, and therefore they show two regional structures. And after that, now also, in other words, also we can say that the rotation about carbon nitrogen bond is hindered, and as a result of this hindered rotation, the peptide bond can show geometrical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism is cis and trans isomerism, and because of much larger steric repulsion between the two alkyl group in the cis isomer and the trans isomer, as compared to the cis isomer, trans isomer is more stable. So this is the most stable trans isomer is shown here. This is the trans and this is cis. So this is less stable because there is a more steric hindrance, and here is it is more stable, and shown here the two structure of this. So here similar groups are present, two alkyls are on the same side, here two alkyls are on the opposite side. So trans and cis isomers of peptide bond is also possible. Another structure is shown here, that polypeptide also show planar peptide bonds, and in this case we can say that it is clear that free rotation of peptide chain can occur only around the bonds joining nearly planar amide group to the alpha carbon. It is therefore possible to describe the conformation of protein molecule or the polypeptide chain in terms of angle between alkyl CH-NH bond, and therefore these angles are called Ramachandran angle. Because it is he is the biophysicist Ramachandran. He introduced this angle, and therefore the name is given Ramachandran angle. So it is also shown, and in this slide it is also shown, this is the segment of polypeptide showing planar peptide bond in the box, and theta or psi as a bond angle here. This theta and this is psi. This is the Ramachandran. This is the angle. This is shown by Ramachandran, and therefore it is known as Ramachandran angle of rotation. Theta or psi, both these angles introduced by this Ramachandran scientist, and therefore known as Ramachandran angles. And here is shown around the alpha carbon. So this is the alpha carbon. Around these two angles are there, and this CONH peptide link, this CONH is the, they are in a same plane. And so this structure of this peptide bond is shown. And here, this is another structure of this peptide bond or peptide linkage. So, structure of this compound can be suggested. And here, one method is there, that is the classical peptide synthesis. Number of methods are there, this is classical method. And in case of classical peptide synthesis method, we have to take the amino acids, alpha amino acid. When two different amino acids are allowed to react in the presence of dehydrating agent beside the reaction, NH2 group of one amino acid and COH group of the other, there are equal chances that reaction may occur between the COH and NH2 group of the two molecules of the same amino acid, and giving mixture of dipeptide. For example, when glycine and alanine are heated together in the presence of dehydrating agent, a mixture of four different dipeptide is formed. For example, if you take glycine and alanine, there is a loss of water, and glyala, different types of dipeptide compounds can be formed, just in one example. And now another example is shown here in the slide, that the condensation reaction between the two amino acid molecule to form peptide bond is an endothermic reaction, and hence does not take place easily. overcome low reactivity of the CUH group towards the nucleophilic substitution reaction by the NH2 group of the other amino acid, the carboxyl group of one amino acid molecule is activated by converting it into the acid chloride and then allowing it to react with the second amino acid. The problem is that still remain is that the activated acid chloride can also react with another molecule of its own as well as other amino acid. To understand this problem, we consider the synthesis of alanine glycine. And for this case, carboxyl group of alanine is first activated by converting it into its acid chloride and then allowed to react with the glycine. So alanine chloride amino group of another molecule of alanine chloride give the dipeptide ala, that as a result of this, yield of this desired dipeptide will decrease. It will have been separated from other dipeptide, which itself quite difficult. So separation is very difficult, and to overcome this problem, amino group of the amino acid is first protected before its carboxyl group is activated by converting it into acid chloride. So here is one reaction is shown how it is a combination is taking place. This is alanine chloride and this is the glycine. There is a loss of HClH and ClCONH linkage here. We get alagly, and this alagly is here now another molecule of this glycine here, compound of this alanine chloride, and alanine chloride react with this two molecules, then HCl is replaced and here forming this type of ala compound. So this is a ala glyc and this is another ala compound. So in this case, this is the this method is there of that is classical method, but this classical method have some drawbacks, and the drawback of this method and important point of this classical method. About this method of the synthesis of polypeptide, this synthesis involve stepwise condensation of amino acid molecule, can be carried out successfully and used to synthesize oligopeptide, but synthesis of large peptide containing hundreds of molecule of amino acid by this method is very difficult task, and there are two drawbacks. One is a time consuming, second is a low yield. In case of time consuming, the classical method of peptide synthesis requires several steps involving protection, activation, condensation and deprotection for each new peptide bond to be formed, and therefore therefore this process is very tedious and time consuming. Second drawback is it give a low yield. Since the process involves number of steps, the overall yield goes on decreasing after each extension, even though each individual step has excellent yield of 80%. So these are the two drawbacks of this classical peptide synthesis. And next is that formation of peptide bond. As we have seen how the peptide bond is formed, it is shown here after the reaction of the amino group, activation of the carbonyl group, carboxyl group of this N protected amino acid is allowed to react with the same or different free amino acid when peptide bond is formed. So here is shown how one reaction of the formation of peptide bond. So this is the benzoxyl carbonyl amino acid chloride with alpha amino acid, and at this temperature in the presence of THF, HCl is replaced and we get CONH linkage. That is known as benzoxy carbonyl dipeptide, Z protected dipeptide. So in this way, we have to protect it by using some compounds, and this is one example of formation of peptide bond. So here we have seen different types of polypeptides and what is peptide, nomenclature of peptide, and after that also we have seen the formation of peptide bonds and the classification of peptide bonds, and after that we have seen the different types of properties of these peptides. So these are the different types of peptides that we have discussed today in this presentation. So today we have discussed what is peptide, what are the types of peptide bonds, our peptide linkage, and after that we have seen the classification and then the structure of polypeptides and peptide bonds, formation of peptide bonds, and the synthesis of peptide linkage or peptide compound by using the amino acids. So CONH is the peptide bond or peptide linkage, and we have discussed the formation of this peptide linkage by using alpha amino acids.